Hey, thanks for joining us today. Congratulations on starting a new season. Welcome back.
Thank you. We're excited. It's going to be another great season here in Sacramento, and another opening day for me. It's been this is my 15th year managing, and this is my sixth season with Sacramento. So it's a lot of good memories, and hopefully we can go out there and have another great night.
Back-to-back PCL championships, one of them is yours. Any pressure to that, or is it just a part of the legacy you guys like to live up here?
Yeah, no pressure. I think the guys are just going to come out and have some fun. And, our motto this year is that this is going to be our new memory. So all the memories we had over the years, the last championships, those teams will remember them. They'll get their rings tonight. But today we start something new for the 2009 Rivercats.
A lot of new guys. What does it look like for you all this season?
Well, it looks pretty good. We got some veterans coming back. We got a young pitching staff. Tonight we got one of our top prospects, Vinny Mazzaro, pitching for us, and he'll be fun to watch out there. Right fielder named Sean Doolittle, who is one of our top prospects. So it's a mix of combination of veterans and young guys, and our job is to get these guys ready for Oakland.
Is your job as hard as any within the organization from the standpoint? When we look at the pictures that are on the outside of this clubhouse, there are like 60 or 70 guys on a roster, and you guys could have up to 100 guys on a roster at any point during the season. I mean, you've got to really juggle a lot of personalities and a lot of different people and personnel as Oakland calls somebody up and you guys send somebody back down, that type of thing.
No, it makes it fun. I think that's part of my job description is that to get these guys to gel and some chemistry in here. And every time you got a mix of new players that are on their way up or on their way down, you do a lot of talking on the couch, and we try to settle that all our problems inside the clubhouse. This way, when they go on the field, they're ready to play and perform.
Speaking of that, we're inside the clubhouse. It's kind of the home away from home for a lot of guys, is it not? It's a special place to be in, and something that the typical fan doesn't get to see.
Absolutely. If you look around the locker room here, I mean, each one of these little players is like a player's house. It's their private stuff. Nobody's allowed to go in anybody's locker. Everybody respects each other's equipment and their bats and their gear. So. But these tables here are for the players. We come back here, we eat, they play cards, they play backgammon. It's a lot of conversation talking about baseball and preparation. So the clubhouse is a sacred place.
I'm laughing because a lot of the stories that come from a ball club probably come from this room right here.
Absolutely. This is where it all starts. And like I said, when you're with a team for 6 months, a lot of ups and downs. And sometimes, not everybody gets along, but it's my job to keep them on the same page.
All right. Hey, appreciate it. Good luck to you. Welcome back. I was just talking to some season ticket holders. I'm sure you know they're like, we're so happy to see Tony D is back. So
yeah, we're excited.
Good luck. Have a great year this year.
Okay, thank you.